Good afternoon all. So today we will focus on seepage. Seepage it is smallest content of our unit. The seepage is the slow escape of liquid or gas through the porous material or small holes. So this is an actual diagram of gravity dam, and it is an homogeneous dam water surface level. There is the free water surface or seepage lines, and just unstable zones are here, and it is the impermeable foundation is there. Seepage is one of the application of the groundwater hydraulics. The aims of studying seepage in civil engineering: first aim is to find the discharge and seepage through and beneath the structure, to find uplift pressure under the structure. And third is to find solution for foundation and piping failures. Seepage theories. The seepage theory is hydraulic structure may either be founded on an impervious solid rock foundation or on pervious foundation. Whenever such a structure is founded on pervious foundation, it is subjected to seepage of water beneath the structure. In addition to all other forces, the first is the structure is downstream side and upstream side. So there is the H1. F1 is equal to gamma H1 square upon 2. So and H2 is height here, and here is the F2 is equal to gamma H2 square upon 2. So in case of no tailwater, this is an actual gamma H2 square, and this is the B. There is the actual schematic diagram of dam in case of tailwater exist. Seepage theories. Water seeping below the body of hydraulic structure endanger the stability of structure and may cause the failure either by piping and direct uplift. Seepage theories. Failure of piping or undermining. When the seepage water retains sufficient residual force at the emerging downstream end of the work, it may lift up the soil particles. This leads increase the porosity of the soil by progressive removal of soil from beneath the foundation. The structure may ultimately subside into the hollow so formed, resulting in the failure of the structure. This is an soil grains water comes out. This is an soil grains water comes out, and this is the pervious foundations. Foundation material comes out, forming hollow below the dam. So this is the actual structure of failure of piping undermining. Then seepage theory. Failure by direct uplift. The water seeping below the structure exerts uplift pressure on the floor of structure. If this pressure is not counterbalanced by weight of the concrete of masonry floor, the structure will fail by rupture a part of the floor. So this is an actual headwater, and weight of the dam exerted downward, and this is the uplift pressure. This is the hill and toe portion, and this is the tailwater, and it is the actual failure of the dam conditions. Then seepage theories. Generally there are three seepage theories. The first is bailiff creep theory, land weighted creep theory, and Koslas theory. Right now we are focusing on bailiff creep theory and Koslas theories. Seepage theories. First, bailiff creep theory. According to bailiff theory, the percolating water follows the outline of the base of the foundation of the hydraulic structure. In the other words, water creeps along the bottom contour of the structure. The length of the path thus transferred by water is called the length of the creep. That is, the L is equal to LH upon LH plus LV. Further, it is assumed in the theory that The loss of head proportional to the length of the creep. If HL height level is the total head loss between the upstream and the downstream, and L is the length of creep, then the loss of the head of per unit of the creep's length, that is HL upon L, is called hydraulic gradient. Note, Belief makes no distinction between horizontal and vertical creep. Seepage theories. The actual belief creep. This is a diagram of actual belief creep. Consider the section shown in figure above. Let HL be the difference of the water levels between upstream and downstream ends. So HL here HL, the difference of water levels between upstream and downstream end. Water will seeps along the bottom contour. Water will seeps along bottom contour as shown is arrow. As shown is arrow, the water will seeps along the contour. It starts percolating and A and B. It start percolating. It is A and B. B. The total length of creep is given by L is equal to D1 plus D. D1 plus L1 plus D2 plus D2 plus L2 plus D3 and D3. So it is equal to L1 plus L2 plus 2D1 plus 2D2 plus 2D3 is equal to B plus 2 D1 plus D2 plus D3. Seepage theories. Head loss per unit length of hydraulic. This is an actual diagrammatic representation. Length of hydraulic gradient is equal to HL upon B plus 2 D into D1 plus D2 plus D3 is equal to HL upon L. And the head loss is HL upon L is L into 2D into HL upon L into 2D square. Into HL upon L into 2D3
cube
will occur the locations of three vertical cutoffs. The hydraulic gradient line HG line can then be drawn as the shown in figure above. Seepage theories. Safety against piping or undermining. According to belief, the safety against piping can be ensured by providing sufficient creep length given by L is equal to C into HL, where C is the belief creep coefficient of the soil. Difference values of C for the different types of soil are tabulated below. This is the types of soil, this is the value of C, and it is a hydraulic gradient should be less than. So first I am giving first example, fine micaceous and sand. Value C is 15 and hydraulic gradient 1 upon 15. Coarse grained sand, value of C is 12 and hydraulic gradient 1 upon 12. So approximately in between that sand mixed, it is 5 to 9, 5.9 to 1.1 upon 9. 5 upon 1 upon 5 to 1 upon 9. Light sand and mud, value of C 8. And hydraulic gradient is 1 upon 8. Note, the hydraulic gradient, that is H by L, is then equal to H by C. Hence, it may be stated that hydraulic gradient must be kept under a safe limit in order to ensure safety and L. But if and say example, if at any point the ordinate AG line above the bottom of the floor is 1, then the 1 meter head of the water will act up here. At a point, if H meters is this ordinate, then the water pressure is equal to the H meters. H meters will act this point and has to counterbalance by the weight of the floor, say, this key. So here is the pressure gamma, the base upon H, where the gamma is the weighting at above the water pressure gamma W G into T, where G is the severe weight of the material. Ratio equal to gamma W H is equal to gamma W into G into T. So H is equal to G into T, subtracting T both sides will get H T minus T, G is equal to T minus T is equal to T, G minus 1 is equal to T.